और एक दो मैं उदाहरण देता हूं जो कि ऐसे नहीं आया, इट डिडंट कम फ्रॉम पार्टिसिपेटरी ग्राउंड वाटर मैनेजमेंट. व्हाट एक्चुअली हैपेंड वाज सम फॉर्म ऑफ पीजीडब्ल्यूएम. फॉर एग्जांपल द सिटी ऑफ बेलगाम इन कर्नाटका, विच इज इन नॉर्थ कर्नाटका, 5 लाख आबादी है बेलगाम की. इट ड्रॉस वाटर फ्रॉम अ डैम अबाउट 14 किलोमीटर अवे एंड अनदर डैम विच इज अबाउट 28 किलोमीटर अवे. इन अ पर्टिकुलर ईयर ऑफ ड्राउट दे रैन आउट ऑफ वाटर इन द डैम्स एंड वन ऑफ द लोकल इंजीनियर्स, अ जेंटलमैन कॉल्ड एसआर नायक, remembered that there were open wells in the city and that Sarem Vishveshwaraya, when he had drafted a report for the city, had said that this open wells will be sufficient for Belgaum's water needs, but since I want to try out pipe water supply, I'm going in for the dams. So with the help of the community, they cleaned up those open wells. So this was community participation. The city government did not put in a naya paisa. People were immersing Ganeshas, throwing garbage and so on and so forth. That was stopped. Fencing was built up around it and pumps were lowered by the municipality after cleaning up the well by the community. The community undertaking to take care of the well and not allow it to become a garbage dump, and it was linked to the water supply of the city of Belgaum. Like wells like this, for example. Beautiful old large open wells. So now these wells have expanded to fit in into the city infrastructure. About 81 wells have been cleaned up by communities and integrated. Another 400 wells are available for cleaning up and getting integrated. 400 aur kuen hain. All these have come in and they're providing water reasonably well and at 76 paisa a kiloliter. Meaning the cost of production of water is the lowest for an open well as compared to water from a dam, simply because of the pumping charges. So it gives you the opportunity of carrying through a pro-poor policy or a human rights to water better if you ecologically understand and minimize the investment cost of capital and O&M, and if you do that in conjunction with the community, where the community is informed about the resource and they take care of it, it's a win-win-win situation. And so there are examples at city scale where this has happened. This is the same city where there's a 24/7 also working in some 10 wards. Now it'll be interesting to see how the wells are talking to the 24/7. It doesn't look like they are. So I'm talking about a small place called Rainbow Drive. This is just down the road here. And it's a gated community. It does not represent a heterogeneous community. It doesn't represent sub class ke log nahi hai. Khali ek middle income or rich income class ke log hai yahan pe. Par yahan pe 360 site hai aur 37 acres hai. Aur yahan BWSSB, water supply utility ka pani nahi aata hai. So people had to manage their own water. So what they did was they set up a regulation under the Associations Act where they banned private borewells. So when the state does not permit a legislation to drill or not drill borewells, associations and apartments can become innovative in using different legal instruments to do that banning and to convert private water resource into a community property resource. So this is what they did. They put in 360 recharge wells. They only had 3 borewells to pump water and distribute to everybody, and they put in place a tariff measure. And so there are some number crunching which we engineers love, but which becomes important. What we found when we intervened was the average consumption was about 265 to 270 liters per capita per day. The city designs its water supply systems at 135 LPCD. People are consuming 265 to 270, certain section of the people, which means certain section of the people will have to consume less, right? But when it comes to sustainability of groundwater as a resource, and we do start taking the numbers, how much water are we pumping out? Depending on that, how much are we consuming? And therefore, how much is the aquifer getting depleted? Once we consume a lot more water, we generate a lot more sewage. Sewage treatment also requires a cost. So consumption of excess water has a double whammy, aquifer depletion and increased sewage cost or increased sewage flows. How do you deal with it? So this was dealt with by talking to the community and saying, if you reduce your water consumption to 150 LPCD, you will be sustainable vis-a-vis your aquifer. आपका ग्राउंड वाटर जो है वो आपको उतना पानी देगा कि आप 150 LPCD ले सके. यदि उससे ज्यादा करें तो आपके बोरवेल खाली हो जाएंगे. एंड सो दैट्स व्हाट दे डिड. सो फ्रॉम अ डेफिसिट ऑफ 32 मिलियन लीटर्स पर ईयर, दैट इज अ डेफिसिट इफ दे कंज्यूम्ड एट अ हाई नंबर, दे एक्चुअली वेंट टू अ सरप्लस ऑफ 2 मिलियन लीटर्स पर ईयर. दे देमसेल्फ्स डिड इट बाय प्राइसिंग बट बाय कम्युनिटी इंटरेक्शन. एंड now have disposable wastewater came down from 76 million liters to 44 million liters. You will go and see that they are working on treating it and pushing it back into the cycle. So net, they will be 46 million liters surplus in a small geographical pocket. In that pocket itself, unlike Pepsi or Coke, who are surplus with actions everywhere else. So this is also important. Your net positive footprint should be in your geographical context, and it should therefore then provide for the community. What this community now does is to engage with three lakes upstream to try and protect that, revive that, so that the entire area benefits. And a lot more people from communities go here to learn, deal with it. But the people are solving the problem on their own. There are no consultants helping them, or there are no technical people helping them. They're running a fight audit system on their own. So, about 20,000 liters, the tariff was 150 rupees a kiloliter. Within 1 month, everybody came down below 20,000 liters. Within 1 month, one bill more than 150 rupees a kiloliter, everybody dropped to the number. And they stuck to that number. Sorry? Every house is metered by them. The borewells are all three interconnected, and every house is metered, and they read the meters themselves. All the basic three of them. So there's another one like this. This is on the south of the city. Look at the size of the well. Kuwa hai wo. Jab samajh mein aaya ki unke site mein hai, to unhone 120 truckload mitti nikali kuwe se. 120 truckload. Aur wo mitti ko bhi unhone apne garden area mein, landscape area mein rakha. Aur upar upstream area mein recharge structures banaye. Ab wo kuwe mein pani hai. That well is sufficient to get them water for the whole year, if they want. They still have to move to set up a treatment plant and get the water and distribute it. But it's possible. No, they cleaned up the well. They removed 120 truckloads of silt from it. It was lying filled with silt. They protected it as part of their park and landscaped area. And then they did recharge in the upper areas of the recharge zones. This is in the discharge zone. So with that cumulative effect, the well has filled up and it can be used now. And it can be a local source of water for them. So, and there are well diggers who are a traditional community who have started getting employment because they have to make recharge wells. So the benefits have to be captured as social benefits, not simply technical or fungible benefits of water alone. So I say karna hai. And so I'll stop at that because I don't think I want to go along. The new resource in cities is treated wastewater, which will become available for you to fill lakes to recharge aquifers. And we have to position that in a financial model by which it makes sense for you to treat wastewater. Abhi tak kya hota hai? Ki ek sewage treatment plant laga hai, chahe wo Yamuna mein ho ya Ganga pe ho, it's a cost center. Pehle to paisa kharch karna padta hai usse banane mein, phir usse chalane mein bhi paisa kharch karna padta hai. Aur usse paisa kuch aata nahi hai. To hume is dhang se sochna hai ki kya wo kam se kam break even kar le. Yani, jitna paisa us pe kharch ho raha hai, utna to kam se kam wapas aa jaye. And so we need to imagine wastewater and groundwater together. Bas ek do cheeze dikha deta hu aapko pani ke bare mein. Ye ek talab hai which is 53 hectares called Jakkur. Aur isme aap teen cheeze dekhenge. Sabse upar ek sewage treatment plant hai, dikhai de raha hai. See that sewage treatment plant, then you see a wetland, a small cut off portion, and then the lake. The link is treated sewage into a wetland, further polishing, removal of phosphates and nitrates, and then into the lake. Like so. So you have to integrate the conventional and the ecological together, because you have to live with the BWSSB, which cannot design a wetland. The BWSSB can only design a sewage treatment plant. The Lake Development Authority can only develop a lake. It can't make a wetland. So somebody has to intermediate and make that happen. It is mandated in Bangalore that if you consume more than 50,000 liters of water per day, be it an apartment or a layout, you have to have your own sewage treatment plant. So they had a sewage treatment plant. They were treating the sewage. And after treatment, they were letting it out into the sewage line. But what had happened was, because there was ignorance, it was sewage in and even sewage tougher out. Sewage out. Even worse sewage out. Because the management capacity wasn't there. But once they started to do this water business and understand what the hell is going on, the first focus of inquiry was the sewage treatment plant. What is this doing? The contractor ko 26,000 rupees a month. De rahe the. Wo bate bate le raha tha, kuch kaam nahi kar raha tha. So all that was set right when an enlightened community started to interact. And you see that as an upsurge. Not only a lot of people engaging with lakes, a lot of people engaging with sewage treatment plants, with water, with rainwater harvesting. That's all happening right now. So let me just show this. This is how a sewage treatment plant, one of the types, works. The big debate is what technology to use. Abhi wo saaf nahi hua hai. Yahan pe ek technology use ho raha hai, which is called upflow anaerobic sludge blanket and extended aerator. But the location is very important. Yahan pe hai sewage treatment plant aur aap lake dekh rahe ho. It's upstream of the lake. Huh? तो पूरा जितना भी सुएज आता है वो लेक के अंदर सीधा नहीं घुस सकता, पहले सुएज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट के जरिए ही घुसेगा, ट्रीटेड सुएज ही घुसेगा. द एसटीपी हैड अबाउट 19 to 20 crores बीडब्ल्यूएसएस बीन्स इन्वेस्टमेंट, 22 to 23 crores वॉज द बीडीए इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द लेक एंड द वेटलैंड. देयर इज नो कॉस्ट. If you get some plants and put it there, the wetland is emerging. Yeah. So this, it requires some mali and a few plants. So nature as further treatment. So you're looking at part conventional treatment of sewage and part nature as treatment. Huh? No, but or lake ecosystem. Stormwater drain is also with a barrier. Ki kachare ko bahar rakha jaye aur fir saaf paani andar aaye, and then you have pelicans. So then this is what you need to work out in the imagination of the city. Water cannot only be flowing in pipes and flowing out in pipes. The imagination of the city for water should go beyond piped water supply. It should look at the entire gamut of the role that water can play, including spiritual, cultural, historical, ecological, environmental, and groundwater base. Ye design hona chahiye. This is what we call a water-sensitive city. So the one factor that kicks in urban areas is wastewater and garbage, to scales which are unimaginable. So that's one difference. And pipe water is not necessarily a rural construct. It's community stand posts and borewells or hand pumps are also there. But ye ek baat hai na ki ye notice karne layak hai. 200 kg fish milta hai is talab se har roj. 130 rupiah hai kg fish. But look at the irony of it. 200 kgs at 120 rupees a kg. That's 24,000 rupees a day. That's exactly the cost of running the sewage treatment plant. The fish can pay for running the sewage treatment plant. The fish money goes to the fisheries department. The sewage treatment plant bill goes to the BWSSB. Those two departments don't talk. And because they don't talk, STPs won't work. Because the fish are not made to pay for the STP. Seriously, if we get the fish to pay for the STP will run. We have to get the four varieties of fish in the lake to talk to the BESCOM. How do we do that? These are solid urban challenges, Baba. It's very complex. And then the wells are recharged nearby, water heritage structures. Kuwe mein paani hai. Aur kuwe ka paani aapne dekha, 76 paisa kiloliter. The city otherwise pays 80 rupees a kiloliter to get water to itself. Capital cost amortized, O&M cost, sinking fund, 80 rupees a kiloliter. Here it is 76 paisa kiloliter. So the factors of savings in economy, in power consumption, carbon emission, are all high if we get the alignments right. And to get the institutional alignments right, to get the whole construct right so that there is more water for the city, and then, or parallelly, there is equity with universalization of connections, that's the best way to go. And both of them talk to each other. The sludge, 8,000 bucks a day. The sludge value, NPK value, but given away free now. Every day, there is 10 tons of sludge generated every day. The city is setting up wastewater treatment plants for 1,100 million liters per day. There will be 1,100 tons of sludge being generated a day. The city does not have a plan for what to do with it. But these are all sort of misaligned resources. How do you work with it? How do you get them to talk to each other? And then to have these glorious experiences of good, clean, clear water in wells where you can dive and swim and fish and actually have fun, and not be considered a luxury activity, unlike a swimming pool. So I think everybody has a right to enjoy water in all its gamut, right? It's not only a question